Hello everyone and welcome to my Inktober series day 8. I decided to make an entire week of paintings dedicated to Disney. I chose to paint the most known and distinctive Disney characters, the Mickey Wells ones, on an Halloween spoopy context, of course. Since I really enjoyed the old art style aesthetics, I decided to make the paintings fully black and white, so I'll be basically playing a lot with contrasts and values, which is something that I don't usually do, since I'm used to rely on a huge variety of colors. Since I'm gonna paint such well-made characters, from a character design point of view, I believe this will be a huge learning experience concerning everything about values and such. Today I'm starting with Mickey, of course. I gave him kind of a psycho aura. There's nothing too complex about composition, and you can also see the references I'm using throughout the video. So, now I would like to talk a bit about Disney itself and its impact on my life. The first movie my parents got me was Tarzan. Quoting their words, I was a little child who was a little addicted. I would repeat the movie over and over and over. I loved everything about it, and it felt so amazingly immersive. I would completely forget the world around me. It felt like magic. I spent most of the time of my childhood watching basically all Disney movies, as long as other great classics like Looney Tunes, Tom and Jerry, The Pink Panther, and later on I got on the world of anime as well. Till this day, I can say that the most enjoyable moments I have ever lived were and still are watching animated movies like those. Which means that a huge part of my personality was probably deeply influenced by this. I believe that I was always more mature than most kids around me thanks to those movies. Understanding what was going on around me was never really any hard for me, and watching those movies felt kinda like living an adventure alongside the characters, so it felt enriching in so many ways. I can also remember thinking to myself from a really young age about the beauty on everything there, from the places to objects to people, animals. It was as good as it could get. And then again, that feeling of fulfillment and joy is the same till this day. I would always be watching animated series if I could. So, to conclude this subject, I believe that most of my sensibility towards art was greatly boosted by the great influences I had as a kid, and for that I'll always be thankful to my parents. If there's something that I'll never forget, that's it. Well, another thing that I'd like to mention is that I've also always been a great enthusiast about practicing art. I've been doing so ever since I remember existing. I enjoy all medias, from traditional to digital, pencil to oil, Photoshop to Procreate. Everything's enjoyable for me. There are tons and tons of boxes full of drawings I did as a kid, and I certainly didn't slow down as I grew up. Even though animated movies and paintings were always the loves of my life, I didn't really take it as something that could be my career until a lot later, around the age of 16. And I didn't even realize that I could choose that path myself. It was a really, really important person that showed me that it was foolish to not think about it as a possibility. And so my world turned around and I suddenly realized how much I wanted it. I don't see myself as an animator. I feel strongly connected to character design and creating two-dimensional pieces in general. I am just starting this journey, and right now my goal is to create a portfolio that includes a little bit of everything I would like to work on. And some of those things I'm still learning. Since I've never had the time to practice everything, I have focused on portraits until now. But I want to learn about painting objects, buildings and landscapes. Once I have a couple pieces of each that I'm really proud of, I'll start searching for work on companies and as a freelancer, and try to find my way around all of this. I also already have a few products that I've made along the way that you can find on my Etsy shop. And this is it for today. I hope you had fun listening to all of this rambling. I'm really happy about my Mr. Psycho Mickey, and for tomorrow you can count on some Donald Duck. I'll see you soon. Bye bye!